Hey there guys, it's time for a brand new Let's Play. So, as the camera starts to focus, we can see space and a spaceship appear, and it kind of looks like a Pokeball from the front. And who's in it? It's our good friend, Captain Olimar. And in comes an asteroid, which spells ominous doom for our brave little exploring friend. As the asteroid smashes against his starship. And for some reason does not destroy it, because that would end this LP really quick if it did. But anyways, Olimar loses control, enters the atmosphere of this unknown planet that surprisingly looks a lot like Earth. And his ship breaks into pieces as he plummets towards the planet, flaming bits of wreckage falling off and crashing into the woods below. Pretty sure you figured out by now that this LP is Pikmin, the GameCube classic made by Shigeru Miyamoto himself. That man's a genius. So this, I have really fond memories of this game, because it was one of the first two games I bought along with my GameCube. The other one was obviously Melee, because if you don't have Melee, you don't have a GameCube. Anyways, my name's Captain Olimar. While traveling through space, my ship was struck by a meteor. I must have blacked out, and I awoke on the surface of a weird planet. With so many parts lost, the skeletal hull of my beloved dolphin is a painful sight to behold. My atmospheric sensors indicate this planet's environment contains high levels of poisonous oxygen. My life support systems couldn't function for only 30 days. If I can't repair the dolphin by then, no, better not think about it. I must find the missing ship parts. So there we go, basic plot introduction. He's stuck on the planet, the atmosphere is poisonous, he needs to find all of his ship parts and go home. Before he runs out of life support. And we stumble upon this weird thing which suddenly starts glowing bright red and pops out of the ground with three long spider legs. And it drops a single seed into the ground. A strange thing has appeared before me. I had barely begun my search when it reared up as if it were waiting for me. It then dropped a single seed. What is it? Is it alive? Is it a machine? It resembles a vegetable on my home planet that we call an onion. I shall call this an onion too. Okay, so they have onions where Olimar is from. Do they have like French fries? Or cheeseburgers? That would be nice. Okay, the seeds turn into like a little sprout with a single leaf on top. It's kind of cute. The seed the onion dropped took root in the soil and has now produced an adorable little sprout. The sprout emits a strange light and it sways back and forth without the benefit of wind. I cannot help but think it is calling to me. I'm compelled, I must approach it and press A. He actually thinks he needs to press A. Wow, that's kind of creepy, Olimar. Anyways, there he is, a little red guy with a leaf on his head. Extraordinary. When I plucked the sprout, it turned out to be a living creature, not a plant. Picking it has done no visible damage. It just stands there, staring at me. Its shape is similar to the Pik brand carrots I love so much. I believe I shall call it a Pikmin. Here I am, stranded on a toxic planet, fighting to survive, and yet I'm intrigued. I must research this fascinating creature. I shall try to grab it and throw it with A, and I will call it to my side with B. Perhaps it will react to C and X as well. Yeah, because that's the first thing you think about when you discover a new creature. How do I throw it and how do I call it back to me? The following control spirits allow me several viewpoints, L, R, and Z. I must survive. I need to familiarize myself with these controls and my surroundings. Okay. Okay, so that's how the camera works. You go and get that. So we need to start amassing an army. There we go, little pellets absorb into the onion. And two more seeds come out. It's reproducing. And it's not rated R or rated T. Astonishing, the onion has sown more seeds. The small red pellet the Pikmin harvested after cutting down a flower appears to be some sort of fruit type that can propagate more Pikmin. The onion seems to be a sort of incubator. Needless to say, I must study this strange life form more. Well, there's another one, so let's go get it. And now let's explore our surroundings a little, shall we? There's our crashed ship. Oh, did not mean to do that. Come on, get over here. Let's get these guys out of there. I mean, the more the merrier. Because Olimar is kind of feeling lonely and can use a friend about now. Let's... I think I saw some more pellets up here. Let's go and get them. There's a big one. We need 5 Pikmin to carry that, and we only have 3 so far. So you carry that, and we'll go looking for more. Maybe over there? No. That's a bummer. Oh well. Let's just see if we can get that one. Oh, there's another one. Come here. You guys are way too slow, man. Need to keep up. Okay. You come over here. Stop doodling off. Pay attention when I'm talking to you, damn it. Okay, we have 4. Let's just help that one get it back faster. And then we can go get the big one over there. We need 5 Pikmin to carry it, but oh, it'll give us massive numbers of Pikmin, hopefully. Come here. You go and get him. 5 Pikmin on the job, and then we can go about picking these ones. There we go, that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. They do make the cutest squeals when you pull them out of the ground, don't they? Okay, you can help them for now. Come on, you stop dawdling and pick that thing up. Alrighty, let's see how many seeds we'll get from this. Get over here. Ah, we get like 5. For some reason I thought you get 10 from those. Seems like if the pellet's the same color as the onion, I'm pretty sure the number on it gets doubled, but apparently not. Maybe I was mistaken. I mean, the pellets that say 1 on them get doubled, but then why doesn't the 5 pellet? Oh well, let's just yank him out of the ground and see if we can do anything else here. Come on, my Pikmin army. A box with 10. Okay, if you throw 10 Pikmin against it, they move the box and we can move to a new area. So that's pretty damn awesome. And I can see lots more red pellets over there, so we'll be reproducing a lot more Pikmin. Come on. Almost done. There we go. The Pikmin are as curious as children. They form groups to perform tasks that would be impossible for an individual. A glimmer of hope has begun to shine in my heart. If I can make use of their skills, perhaps I can fix my ship. I shall sum up all I've learned of Pikmin conduct. Approach and press A to pick sprouts, press A to grab Pikmin, release to throw, press B to call them, X to dismiss, use C to command and control the group, L, R, and Z control perspective. I shall record all of this on my computer. I can press Y to access the computer. And the entire controller starts lighting up like a goddamn disco ball. Okay, 14 Pikmin. Okay, what's that over there? It's a piece of machinery and it's shaking all over the place. What is it? And it shines, sparkles. It's pretty. Amazing, there's no mistaking it. My ship's engine rests before my very eyes. By a stroke of pure luck, I have already stumbled upon the most important piece of my damaged craft. Fate has smiled upon me, but how will I get it back to the dolphin? That's where slavery comes in. Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't really think about it underneath the game's cute appearance, but this is downright slavery. I mean, you got this alien who comes to this planet, commanding all these little tiny plant guys who really can't make any decisions for themselves, and you then pretty much let them carry your stuff. It's downright slavery, man. I mean, how could Miyamoto make a game that promotes slavery? But then again, he also made Mario Brothers and all another genius crap, so we'll forgive him. Because he's like the most awesome man in the world. He's like the man every man wants to be. Although I did read a little piece of news about Miyamoto the other day that kinda changed my perspective of him. When many Pikmin seeds sprout at once, I find it rather tedious to pluck them from the ground individually. My wife always told me I was no good at routine tasks. Oh, great. I guess I'll try to get it all done by at once by repeatedly tapping A until I pick all the Pikmin from the ground. When I add Pikmin to my group, they become filled with excitement and flushed with bright color. At other times, they revert to a paler hue and give off a dim glow. Paying close attention to these differences is bound to help me distinguish between Pikmin. Yeah, that's nice. Anyways, about Miyamoto, like, I read this news article on some gaming site that Miyamoto originally planned to release 15 versions of Nintendogs to replicate the feeling that people get when they're in, like, a pet store picking out a breed of dog. But, yeah, that's just a downright stupid idea. I mean, 15 versions of Nintendogs, I mean, we already have, like, 4. Do we really need those? Just stuff them all in one game. I mean, jeez. Anyways, let's put our little slave workers to haul the engine back to the ship. Because there's no more pallets to be found here. Oh, we can go inside the box. I'm inside the box, I'm using my imagination. Okay, come on, slave workers, can't you move that any faster? I need to get out of here before the freaking day ends. Even though there's no time limit yet on day one. That's something you'll find out in later parts, that each day has a time limit, so you'll have to work pretty fast if you want to get enough parts back to your wrecked ship. And it does indeed look pretty damn wrecked. I crashed it real good, but then again, if you do something, you'd better do it good. Even if that includes crashing your ship. Now, there we go. The ship absorbs the engine, flips itself back up for some reason. And we're good to go. At least not back into space, obviously. Because there's holes in the hull and parts missing and stuff, but at least we can fly again. And Olimar jumps with joy. And the Pikmin skedaddle. Oh, glorious, with the help of these Pikmin, I've taken a huge step back toward home. My ship can once again lift off. A glimmer of hope is beginning to burn more brightly. But what has become of the remaining parts? That search starts tomorrow. Yeah, we've done enough for one day. And there's nothing else we can do here anyway. And the Pikmin run off to somewhere. Yeah, well, a good day's work. They apparently retreated back into the onion. And we'll just go to our ship and leave. Come on, get in. There we go. Time for blast off. Off we go. And wait, the onion's taking off as well? It can fly. It can fly. One day since impact, I've somehow managed to launch the dolphin, but I was surprised to see the onion lift off with me. Perhaps the Pikmin cannot survive overnight on the planet's surface, or have they merely decided to join me for other reasons? Either way, it seems they will help me again tomorrow. The dolphin is missing 29 parts. If I can't recover them all, I may never return home to my family on planet Hawketate. Analysis shows life support systems will function for only 29 more days. How can I repair my dolphin in such a short time? A dense forest is visible on the surface below. As it holds the key to my survival, I shall name it the Forest of Hope. I explore it tomorrow. Well, we have 29 days to discover 29 parts, so pretty much if you do one part a day, you'll still be fine, as long as you don't mess up. So we'll save, and then I'll see you in the next part of Pikmin when we go and explore the Forest of Hope. So see you guys then. Bye-bye.